Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. This is the third video on regex. In this video we'll see how to parse show version output from the device. So first we'll try running the script and see what are the values we're going to fetch. Here you can see I'm getting all these output from show version command. So for creating this regex pattern, I already have saved show version output into a text file. Rather than communicating with device, we will try to pass from this text file and then we'll apply to the device. So for saving all this configuration file, we have used another script here. So you can see the file here, command output to txt. So use this command. I have explained this script in the previous video. I'll add that video URL in the notification and description. Now let's move into the show version output parsing. So for parsing the output, I'll be using RE library in Python. So that is having capability of regex pattern support. And you can use this regex101.com website that gives a really good interface for validating your regular expression. So what we'll do, we'll go and copy the content. So this was the show version output which we saved from the previous video. So let me just copy that. I'll put it here. So first we'll try getting the version. So here you can see, after putting the content, you can select Python 2.7, and here we can just give the string which we need to match. We'll see what is R here. I'll explain that. Now if you want to match, if you want to see the version number, you can see version number is here. The line starts with Cisco. So to match the word Cisco, you can see, you can give it like this. So you can see it matched Cisco in multiple places. Now if you want to match even the small letter C, what you can do, you can add that in a square bracket. So any one of these characters will match. So let's have a look into that. So here you can see, used to indicate a set of characters which you need to match. So even you can give it like this. So you can see a combination 0 to 9 and A to Z. Like that also you can give. Let us try giving that. If I give capital A to Z, so you can see capital C comes in between that. Now small A to Z, so you can see that considered even small C as well. Now if you want to add some numbers, comma 0 to 9, and if I change any of this letter to 0, you can see that also matches here, because any of these character comes, it will match. You can even give another number, so it matches everything. And similar to that, either you can give small C or capital C. Even another methods are there, like ignore case. We will have a look into those later. Now in our case, we will be fetching version from here. So what we can do, we can give capital C itself. And here one more thing, instead of I, if you give a dot, it matches everywhere. You can see here. Let's see what is dot means here. So this matches any character except a new line. So you can see here it matches any character. So instead of I can give T. So you can see it matched even that letter as well. Anything it will match. Now there is another option here. If you give this caret, let me change this to I, and I'll give caret. So here you can see from every line, wherever this starts with Cisco only comes. Let me just try giving a square bracket here. Yeah, and now we can see in two places it came. And similar to that, you can even give a dollar symbol here, which means it should end with Cisco. So let us try giving one Cisco here for testing. So you can see here it matches here. Now if you give caret here, so it is not matching. So let me just give enter. So you can see here Cisco comes in the starting of the line. I'll remove this. Now we have seen how to use dot, caret and dollar symbol. Now let's have a look into how to use this asterisk symbol. So here you can see it matches zero or more repetition of any character. So let's have a look. I'll remove all this. Now here we have a character I, and let me just give a star here. So you can see here I became an optional value here, you can see here. But even if I add I multiple times, it will match because I have given a star here. So that means zero or more time. And if I give multiple S, it won't match. But if I give a star here, you can see even it matches with S. Okay, now we'll see what is plus. So here, if I give a plus, still it matches all the Cisco. Now if I remove this, so you can see I is not matching here. But if I give multiple I's here, it will match. But we need minimum one. So that's what here plus means. So you can see here, so the letter should match one or more repetition. Similar to that, for matching our version number, so we'll take version from here. Now for the space either you can give slash s, you can see everywhere it is matching this space, or even you can give like simple space, and then I'll give a dot. So if you give dot, you can see everywhere it matches the first character. Any character comes, it will match. So you can see here, any character it matches. Now here, if I give a plus, you can see it matches till the end. So this is the greedy character of this plus symbol. So it went till the end. Let us try giving question mark here. So you can see it matched only in the least matched character. Now what we'll do, we need to verify here this value. Software common version will try giving that. So what I'll do, software comma version. So let's see why it is not matching, because here there is a typo. Let me just try giving a space here, so you can see here now it matched. Now you can see after version again there is a space. So what we can do, dot plus. If you give dot plus again, it matched all the other character till the end of the line. So now you can see here it is a full match. But we need to take only this value. So what we can do here, instead of even dot plus, what we can do, we can give a slash capital S and plus. So that means a slash capital S means a non-space character. Now let's have a look into that. Now we have seen this dot, caret symbol, dollar symbol, star, plus. So this gives an optional value, like this can be this can match 0 or 1 repetition of the character. For example, in Cisco, if we give one more S and question mark, so what will happen here? See, this second S is an optional value. Even if I give one more S, it will match. Yeah. Now we need to add this into a particular group so that we can fetch only this value. So the group we can create using a bracket. So you can see here it came in group 1. Now if you need, you can add a slash n as well. It is end of the line. So now let's go to our Python script and start adding this logic. Okay, so you can see a r here. R means it is a raw string. So let's see why we are using raw string. Here I have a empty Python file. Here we'll see why we are using raw string. So here I'll create a string, s equals slash t. So you can see here slash t, when we use a normal string in Python, slash t is having a special value. Let us try running it. So you can see here it automatically added a tab here. So we'll try giving slash n. So you can see here it printed in next line. Similar to that, if I add a slash t again, you can see here it is automatically adding a tab, because Python is detecting that as a next line or tab. To avoid that, what we can do, we can use a raw string. So you can see it has overridden the special consideration or special meaning of that. Now you can see it is printing as it is. That's why we are using R when we define the regex pattern. So now let's create an object for that pattern what we created. So for that we need to import the library RE. Now I'll give the object name version pattern equals RE dot compile. So RE dot compile means it will create a RE object. So let's have a look into that.